हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अनकॉमन लिटरेचर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद राइम ऑफ एशियन मेरिनर एंड विद पार्ट 3। सो लेट अस बिगिन। देयर पास्ड अ वेरी टाइम, ईच थ्रॉट वॉज पास्ड एंड ग्लेज्ड ईच आई। सो हियर ही इज सेइंग दैट देयर वॉज अ टाइम इन विच वी ऑल वर टायर्ड, वी ऑल वर वेरी, ईच थ्रॉट वॉज पास्ड। सो यू मस्ट बी अवेयर दैट दे डोंट हैव एनीथिंग टू ड्रिंक, दे डोंट हैव एनीथिंग टू ईट, सो देयर थ्रॉट इज पास्ड कम्प्लीटली। पास्ड मीन्स कम्प्लीटली ड्राई एंड ग्लेज्ड ईच आई, सो दे आर लुकिंग एट ईच अदर। अ वेरी टाइम, हाउ ग्लेज्ड ईच वेरी आई। So same thing is being repeated. When the lines are being repeated, it only intensifies their plight. When looking westward, I beheld a something in the sky. So looking towards the west, mariner, the ancient mariner saw something. At first, it seemed a little speck. So at first, when he saw something towards the west direction, there was a sort of point. Speck means a pinpoint something, and then it seemed a mist, and suddenly that point is growing larger. It moved and moved and took at last a certain shape. I wish. So he is saying that I think it was moving and moving ahead, and in the end it took a certain shape. A speck, a mist, a shape, I wished. So he is saying it was earlier a speck, pinpoint, a mist, a little larger, and then it was a complete shape. And still it neared and neared. So it was coming nearer and nearer, as if it dodged a water sprite. It plunged and tagged and veered. So it was coming as if there was something moving over the water. It plunged and tagged and veered, meaning that it was coming to the water. And it was coming near to them. And all these three words, plunged, tagged, and veered, are used to show that the ship was moving and it was coming nearer to them. Okay, so there was a ship and which they saw and it was coming to them. Okay, so with throats unslaked, with black lips baked. So by this line you can understand that with throats unslaked, meaning that their throats were completely dried up, with and their lips became baked, and that is why they were looking like black. We could not laugh nor wail. So they could neither laugh and they could nor wail, meaning they were not able to even laugh or cry because their throats were dried up. Through utter drought, all numb we stood. So complete drought they had in their mouth, in their throat, and they were just standing there. I bit my arm, notice this line, I sucked the blood. So what happened? Nobody was able to speak anything. They were just looking towards the ship, and when he tried to speak, he was not able to utter any words. So what happened that he bit his own arm and he sucked his own blood. When he got his throat wet by the blood, he was able to cry, he was able to shout, and cried, "A sail, a sail." Then he said that there was a ship. With throats unslaked, with black lips baked, this line is repeated. Agape, it is just repeated to show that their plight. It is just repeated to show that how much they are dried up. There is no water for them. Agape, they heard me call. Agape means that they all, the other sailors, heard his call with open mouth. So they were very surprised to hear this. Gramercy. Gramercy means this is an expression of thankfulness. They for joy did grin and they showed their teeth. Okay, grin means showing the teeth in order to smile or laugh, and everybody became joyful. And all at once their breath drew in as they were drinking all, meaning that now they had a good breath. they were able to take a sigh of relief. Okay, see, I cried. See, she tags no more. Tags here meaning that to move in the water. Okay, it is used for the ship. Heather, to work us wheel. It simply means that, you know, it was not moving anymore and it was coming nearer to them without a breeze, without a tide. She steadies with upright keel, meaning that now the sudden breeze stopped and it was without any wind, so it was completely still in the water. The western wave was all aflame. The day was well nigh done. Here it means that the sun was setting to in the west, and since they are in the ocean, the wave of the sea are completely looking like flames because of the setting sun. The day was well nigh done. So the day was completely over. Almost upon the western wave rested the broad bright sun. So he is saying that almost it was looking like that the sun is resting upon the western wave, the wave in the west, when that strange shape drove suddenly betwixt us and the sun. And so it was in that direction when they are seeing that ship, they could see the flames were as looking like fire, and through that direction the ship was also coming towards them. And straight the sun was flagged with bars. Heaven's mother, send us grace. So here, since you can imagine that there is an imagery here. So they are looking towards the western direction. The sun is setting, and between the sun and the mariners and the sailors, there is the boat. So you can see it looks like the sun is behind the bars because it is a skeleton of a ship. Okay, as if through a dungeon great he peered with broad and burning face. So the sun here, he is used for the sun, that it was looking as if the sun was looking from a from the bars of a dungeon. Okay, with broad and burning face, and his face was looking like broad and it was looking like burning. Alas, thought I, and my heart beat loud. How fast she nears and she nears. So by looking at the skeleton of the ship, his heart was again sorrowful. And the ship was nearing them very fast. Those her sails that glance in the sun like restless gossamers. So here he is asking that are these the sail of that ship which are looking like the webs of spider. Gossamer means the spider web. Are those her ribs through which the sun did peer as through a grate? Okay, so you know what is a grate. So you know the ship is a skeleton and they can see through the ship, they can see the sun. So they are asking question, the mariner is asking question that are these her ribs? And is that woman all her crew? And they are asking, they can see a woman on the ship, and the mariner is asking question that only the woman is there and nobody else. Is that a death? And are there two? So he is asking, is she alive or is she dead? And are there two? Or there are two people actually. Is death that woman's mate? So he is saying that if the death, the mate of the woman. Okay, now in this stanza he will describe the woman on the ship. Her lips were red, her looks were free, her locks were yellow as gold. Okay, so first line you can understood, and the second line talks about the hair. Her hair were yellow like gold, her skin was white as leprosy. So here you can see that her skin was white as leprosy, is a kind of disease. The nightmare, life in death was she, and he is calling her a nightmare with a name, life in death, who thicks man's blood with cold. And she has you know, an appearance by which a man's blood can be cold, can become very thick, very thick. The naked hulk, now this term naked hulk is used for the ship. The naked hulk alongside came, and the twain were casting dice. So alongside came meaning it came near to them, and the twain meaning the woman and her mate, they were casting dice, and suddenly the woman cries, "The game is done, I have won, I have won," quoth she, and whistles thrice. Okay, so they are playing the dice, and suddenly the woman says, "I have won," and again she whistles thrice. You can notice the number 3 here. So the sun's rim dips, the stars rush out, at one stride comes the dark, with far heard whisper over the sea, off shot the spectre bark. So by this you can understand that it means there is description of the sudden dark. Okay, the sun's rim dips. You can imagine the last outer circle of the sun is compared with a rim, and it dips in the water. The stars rush out, and suddenly the stars come out, at one stride comes the dark. Okay, you can understand this. With far heard whisper over the sea, offshore the spectre bark. And there is a very far heard whisper over the sea, and they can hear the spectre bark. We listened and looked sideways up, fear at my heart as at a cup. My life blood seemed to sip. This line means that by this appearance, by this scenario, he was feeling very scared, and he has told us by that the fear was sipping his blood by taking his blood in a cup. Okay, the stars were dim and thick the night, the steersman's face by his lamp gleamed white. So you can see the stars were dim and the night was very, very dark, and that is why the steersman's face was looking very white. Okay, from the sails the dew did drip, and the dew was dripping from the sails till clomb above the eastern bar, the horned moon with one bright star within the nether tip. So you can understand that they are talking about crescent moon, which looks like horns from two sides, and there is a star. Okay, I think it is the north star. So that imagery is shown that suddenly they have the moon in the sky. One after one by the star dogged moon, too quick for groan or sigh. Remember the understand the first line, that one by one, understand what is happening in this stanza, that one by one all of other sailors collapse on the ground, okay, or collapse on the ship. Okay, and let us see why. One by one after one by the star dogged moon. So this is already the imagery in the previous stanza. Star dogged moon, a moon with a star. Too quick for groan or sigh. So let us see, we will understand this line after understanding the next two lines. Each turned his face with a ghastly pang and cursed me with his eye. So everybody turned their face with some pain and cursed him with their eyes only, without saying anything. So too quick for groan or sigh. So they did not even have time to groan or to take some sigh, and they collapsed. 4 times 50 living men, and I heard nor sigh nor groan. So there was no sigh, no groan. With heavy thump, a lifeless lump, they dropped down one by one. Okay, so there were 4 times 50 living men. So it means 200 men collapsed without uttering any sigh, without uttering any groan. They dropped one by one. The souls did from their bodies fly, they fled to bliss or woe. So you can see that they are dead now. They fell dead on the ship, and he is saying their souls went away from their bodies, they fled to bliss or who, meaning they fled to heaven or hell. And every soul it passed me by, and every soul passed him like the whiz of my crossbow. So last line again takes us to the killing of the albatross by his bow. So the word whiz here is deliberate is deliberately used here in order to remind us the sound of the arrow. Okay, how he killed the albatross by shooting an arrow towards it. Okay, so with this we have completed the third part as well. Thank you so much.